Mr. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This is a conditional use permit by Anthony Tong for a tattoo parlor or studio in OP zoning. We talked about it at the work session. We recognize this from 2 months ago when it was rezoning request by the same applicant. We rezoned this property from RP to OP. Property consists of about a third of an acre located at 307 East James Street. Nothing has changed with the property since. And as we talked about 2 months ago, the purpose of that rezoning request was simply to make this property eligible for a tattoo parlor, which required OP zoning with the conditional use. So the rezoning was approved by City Council, and the applicant is now coming through for his conditional use permit request. Still in the packet, the zoning pattern has been updated a little bit to show the OP zoning. Hair carrier still remains the same as transitional neighborhood. Aerial imagery still shows the same urban street pattern, the trees in the area, subject property, all go through these quickly. These are the same pictures that you saw 2 months ago. It's a former office, or has been an office for many, many years, but empty, I think, most of the past year. Used to be the home of the administrative offices for the Humane Society for many years. The parking lot in the back, also a little bit in the front, the rear doors of the building. This is the view looking down James Street toward Ashley, the actual office immediately to the west, some residential uses across the street. Some of these, I think, are rental, some may be owner-occupied, very much a residential kind of looking corridor. Duplex, another office, this is going to the east, and then some of you may recognize the large brick building that's on the corner with Ashley. So in your packet, you have many of the same informational items. Staff is recommending approval of the conditional use permit, subject to four conditions, and I'll go through these. First one is approval shall be granted in the name of the applicant only for a tattoo parlor or studio business in OP zoning and for the existing building only with no building expansions greater than 100 square feet cumulative. This shall be a single tenant business occupancy with no other tenants' businesses allowed on the premises. You might recall from the zoning case, we talked a lot about different things that are used or allowed in OP zoning. Number two, hours of operation shall be limited to within the hours of 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. daily. Number three, signs shall be in strict accordance with OP requirements without variance. No signs shall be internally lit. There shall be no directional signs, nor any temporary signs, or attention-getting devices of any kind. And lastly, number four, conditional use approval shall expire 1 year from the date of approval if no city business license has been obtained by that date. But answer any questions you may have. The applicant is here.
Commissioners, any questions for staff on this matter? All right, we will now enter the public hearing portion of this case. Is there anyone here this evening that would like to speak in favor of this case? If so, please come forward and state your name and address for the record.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Martin. I just want to give a
Please state your name and address for the record.
Anthony Tong, 307 East James Street.
Hey, we should know you by now.
So I want to give a few clarifications on the things in regards to the sign. So what sign am I allowed and permitted to have?
Freestanding sign, not internally lit, but could be externally lit.
So, not a headstone type of model?
Sure. Monument sign, 36 square feet maximum. In the front yard, pretty standard for an OP kind of thing. The concern, some of the development standards between OP and RP are a little bit different. OP lends into the commercial, which is why some of these restrictions to kind of curtail some of those commercial things, like an internally lit sign.
Yes,
I mean, think about the street, there's really not much other signage. So it's pretty much an RP kind of signage rule.
Contemporary.
Yeah. Okay. You know, we don't get into design or lettering or anything like that. It's really square footage and location that's pretty standard across the districts. So that's the main gist.
I also humbly request that the board consider maybe slightly altering my hours of operation. My current hours of operation are 11 to 8. So The average time spent from a client is about 2.5 to 3 hours. The median income of my office is around $36,000. So there's very limited disposable income spent, and I'm blessed and fortunate that some people want to spend their disposable income with me, however, not at the expense of having to leave work. So a lot of my clients actually come after work at 5 o'clock or they get off at 4, and they get done in the evening. So that could, I mean, probably less than 5% of my clientele could afford to be off of work to come get a tattoo. So between the hours of 3 and 8 and on the weekends are usually more of my peak hours. So I'm requesting that the board maybe consider extending these hours to 10 to 8 or 9 to 8.
Which is ideal for you? I mean, it's...
Yes, sir.
Which one is ideal? 10 day, 9 day?
Either. It's 8 p.m. is really the most ideal. So okay. We open up at 11. My staff comes in to clean up at 10 and prep for opening. So around 10 to 8 would be sufficient. But no activity or work would be rendered after 8 o'clock. And then on Fridays, we would already prepare for the football games and probably close early anyway.
So just curious, Ed, now you may ask my question. So a client probably would not walk in at 7:30 or 7:45 to start then?
No, so a tattoo in my shop can't start past 7 p.m. So the only ones that would go past 7 p.m. are the ones that might have been started at 6 or 5.
Any other questions for Mr. Tong? Thank you, sir.
Yes. Mr. Tong, did you have, prior to submitting this request, did you have communicate with any of the tenants in that area?
Yes, I did. Each one of the tenants on the street.
You did? Do you know Ms. Wanda Five-ish?
Five-ash?
Yes.
No, sir. So I spoke with the surveying company. I also spoke with ACTO. And the residential people that are on both sides of the location. The residential and then the law firm. Mm-hmm. So those were all of my neighbors on my side of the street. And on the other side of the street, I really didn't speak too much to them.
Any other questions for the applicant? Thank you, sir.
One quick note, Mr. Chairman, before I forget completely what's in your packet you received, but we did get a letter of opposition from the nearby property owner, Madison Reed, which I gave hard copies out to you before the meeting. That's the only written communication that we've had that I'm aware of. We've had, I know, one other phone call, but nothing submitted in writing. There's going to be a question as to what we're being asked in relation to the previous request, which was from these applicants.
So this middle didn't come in for the previous request, just this request?
This only came in for the conditional use. There was nothing from these folks.
And just for clarification purposes, and Commissioner Bythewood's question, Ms. Five-Ash is a tenant of the lady who submitted the letter. Just for clarification.
Okay.
All right, is
I don't recognize her name from any of the mailing lists.
I just saw her name just left this.
Okay.
Is there anyone here this evening that would like to speak against this case? Is there anyone here who would like to speak against this case? If so, please come forward and state your name and address for the record. Seeing no one, that closes the public hearing portion of this case. Commissioners, any further discussion?
On the time there, from 7 to 6, you know, he's given up Friday. I don't think it's, you know, moving his evening hours. You have any quarrel about moving it to about 8, 8:30?
I'll tell you where this came from. It was a general concern of it being a more professional office in residential area. So the opening time was not a concern, it was the closing time. Based on a simple notion that most professional offices close at 5 p.m., that's where this came from. Extending it a little bit, I don't think is a great deal. Extending it a lot, I think it's going to be getting out of character of the area. One thing you might consider is, I mean, in his case, it's a little bit unusual and unique that he doesn't take walk-ins right before closing time. There's got to be a flag. What you could do is, in stipulating the hours, and there's no new customers beyond a certain time, and then the business fully closed. makes it a little bit harder to administer, but it would be something, I think, in between what he's wanting to do and what this is.
But you're correct, man. I mean, that's my question to him, and he verbalized that he does not start any new clients after 7 o'clock.
Right.
Now, that it may take an hour or 2 hours to finish that project, but when you how are you going to, you know, to watch that? You can't really. So,
right.
I don't see it. So. I think yeah, I appreciate him being very forthcoming and saying we don't start anything after 7 o'clock.
Commissioners, any other discussion before I ask for a motion? We're at the point where we need a motion.
Madam Chairman, Mr. Chairman, based on this case, the CU-2023-02, Anthony Tong, I make a motion that we approve the request and also the conditions, and I'd like to alter condition number 2 from the stated the 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. to the 11 a.m. to 8 p.m. hours.
All right, we have a motion from Commissioner Bailey to approve with one change in the conditions set out by staff, the hours being instead of 7 a.m. to 6 p.m., 11 a.m. to 8 p.m.?
That's correct.
Yep.
Okay. I'll second.
And we have a second from Commissioner Miller. All those in favor? That was unanimous, Mark.
Good job.
All right, next case on the agenda is